Session. Money has been given the highest priority as the root of all evil. However, money has nothing to do with evil. Evil is within. The evil is the obsession one has for money that lends the impetus to lie or steal or cheat, yes, or even murder. In a moment, you'll hear the story of an evil obsession for money. A story that centers around these moments starring Bonita Granville. This is the story of Cousin Charlie, a man who refused to die, not knowingly, of course. For what man has that conscious right? But in the house of Trina and Jay Crowley, there is desperation that merges into near panic as the days pass. Jay Crowley works for a bank as custodian of money. And at this time of the year, the green and silver of it has none of the joyous glitter of Yuletide. For to Jay Crowley and Trina, money is an obsession.
$321.17 won't buy anything.
That's all that's left, Trina.
How much was it to begin with, Jake?
Almost $10,000.
$10,000? Where has it gone?
Where do you think? You wanted a new car, didn't you? You insisted on that trip to Tahoe last summer. You asked for this house, didn't you?
Oh, so I was the one at fault. I spent the money. I suppose the next thing you'll be saying is that I instigated the whole affair.
Oh, listen, Trina, we won't get anywhere this way. We've got to figure a way out. I need your help.
When are the bank examiners due, Jake?
Next Tuesday.
But can't you cover up some way? Isn't there something you can do?
Not a thing. Since that new manager's been in, I haven't had a chance.
Oh, Jake. Why, I don't know what to say. It's...
The word's larceny, Trina. Grand larceny.
And that's how it began. That was the reason we had to do what we did. We were desperate. There didn't seem to be any way out. No way at all. Then, as though fate had planned it, a letter came. Oh, try and be nice to him, Jake. Cousin Charlie doesn't visit us often.
Well, it's too often to suit me. When's he due in?
Noon train tomorrow. He says we needn't bother meeting him at the station. He'll come ahead to the house.
Oh, that's just dandy. I can hardly wait to hear that cheery laugh of his.
Then there's the one about the two bookies who went to heaven. Have I told that to you?
Is it funny?
It sure is.
Well, then you haven't told it.
Then I haven't told it. Say, that's good. That's real good.
Yes, that is good. Cousin Charlie, I've laid out some towels for you if you want to freshen up. And your room's ready whenever you are.
Oh, thanks. I guess I'll go upstairs and... Say, where's that little traveling kit of mine?
Oh, over there with your suitcase.
Oh, so it is. Getting so I can't see a thing without my glasses. Think I'll take my suitcase up to... Oops, dropped the kit.
Oh, here, I'll get it, Cousin Charlie. You seem to have... you seem to have a lot of money here, Charlie.
Oh, kit come open, didn't it?
It's in cash.
Sure. Just sold a piece of property of mine in Missouri on the way out here. Some funny old codger bought it. Insisted on doing business in cash.
Quite a lot of cash by the looks of it.
Yep, $10,000.
That's an awful lot of money to carry around.
Yes, haven't had a chance to deposit it yet. You know, the funny part of it is, I've been trying to get rid of that property for years. No one to touch it. Then suddenly this fella offers me $10,000 for it. Just like a present, ain't it?
Yeah.
Well, guess I'll go up to my room. Good night, kids.
Good night, Cousin Charlie.
Night.
You know, Jay, I've been thinking, as long as Charlie has the guest room...
$10,000. $10,000, Trina. That'd make up what I'm short at the bank.
Oh, I know. I know, but I don't think...
$10,000.
Jake, Good Lord, Jake.
Cousin Charlie's got $10,000. Tina, you remember Charlie saying he couldn't see very well without his glasses?
Yes. He's always been quite nearsighted.
All right. One of us has to get our hands on those glasses. We break them. Make it appear accidental, of course.
Then?
I've typed this note. We'll find some way to get him to sign it. He won't know what he's signing if he can't read it.
What are you going to use for the...
Potassium cyanide. The encyclopedia says 5 grains are fatal. I can buy it at a photography studio in town. They use it for developing pictures. That way I don't have to sign for it.
Oh, Jake, I'm frightened.
No, you're not. You're not, Trina. You're not... You understand? When people get frightened, they get caught. And you remember that.
But if Charlie should suspect anything... If
Charlie should what?
Charlie.
Good morning. My ears are burning. And what was you saying about me?
Oh, nothing. Nothing at all.
Oh, yes, you were. I heard you.
Heard what?
Heard you mention my name. Come on, what's the secret?
Oh, well, I was just telling Jake if he could fix the water faucet, well, maybe you could. Would you try before you sit down to breakfast, Charlie? It's stuck.
Why, sure thing. Regular handyman, that's me. Which one is it? Let's see. Doesn't seem to be anything the matter with...
Oh, dear, I've splattered your suit, haven't I? I'm so sorry. Here, take this dishcloth. Now, let me have your glasses. I'll dry them.
Oh, that's all right. I can do it.
No, let me. Oh, dear, look what I've gone and done. I've broken your glasses.
Yes, and my only pair.
Oh, I'm sorry, Charlie. I'm terribly sorry. It was later that afternoon. Jake had gone to work, and Charlie and I were on the sun porch. I had but one thought. How was I to get him to sign that note? Then, as if in answer to my question, an article in the magazine caught my eye. Here was the solution. And so simple. Cousin Charlie?
Hmm?
Here's an interesting article.
Yeah?
It's about the different specimens of handwriting. It says that your entire character can be determined just by the way you sign your name.
Yeah?
Uh-huh. And it says if you circle your I's instead of dotting them, you're an extrovert. And if you don't cross your T's, you're an introvert. What are you, Charlie? An extrovert or an introvert?
Oh, I don't know. Anyway, I don't go for that handwriting stuff. It's all a lot of bunk.
Oh, maybe it's not. They have a chart here that explains the whole thing. Here, write your name and let me see if I can analyze your handwriting.
Oh, no, Trina. I think I'd like to take a walk.
Oh, it'll just take a second.
Oh, some other time.
Aw, now, Charlie, don't be a stick. Here, use my pen. Write your name on this piece of paper.
All right. Here. Now, are you satisfied?
Uh-huh. Yes. I'm satisfied. So good. Then the next step. Jake was late getting home that night. Charlie and I had finished supper and he'd gone into the living room. I was straightening up in the kitchen when I heard the car turning in the driveway. Jake came in the back door. Jake, you're late. Where have you been?
The stores were jammed. I had to wait forever at the photography studio.
I was worried about you.
I'm sorry.
Well, you could have called.
I said I was sorry.
You don't have to take my head off. Did you get it?
Yeah. Did you get...
Here.
Oh, Trina, you're wonderful.
I was afraid for a while.
Shh. Here comes Charlie.
Trina, I... Oh, Jake, finally got home, huh?
Yeah.
Well, I just come in to say goodnight.
Oh, are you going to bed so early?
Yeah, gotta get my beauty wings. Well, good night.
Good night, Cousin Charlie.
Night, Charlie. Charlie.
Yeah?
We're just getting ready to fix some tea, weren't we, Trina?
What? Oh, yes, we were.
Why don't you join us in a cup before you turn in?
No, thanks, I don't think so.
Well, then maybe Trina can bring you up a cup after you get to bed. Help you to sleep.
Well, okay. Bring it up when it's ready. Night.
Night.
What's the idea of the tea?
Oh, Trina.
You mean now?
Sure, it's perfect, can't you see?
I'll put the water on. Jake, Let me see that note again.
What's the matter with you? You've seen it.
But we might have left something out. There might be a mistake.
I tell you, it's all right. If it'll make you feel better. Here. Now, is there anything wrong with that?
No, I guess not.
Then put this in his cup. There's 10 grains here.
All right. Wait, Jake.
What's the matter now?
The police will ask where we got the poison.
Oh, Trina, don't you think I've thought of that? Charlie must have found it in the desk. I used it last summer for developing pictures.
Oh, Jake, I'm afraid I'm going to be sick.
You're not anything of the kind. You're all right. Everything's planned perfectly. I'll take that tea up to Charlie.
All right.
Go ahead. Up the stairs.
Yes, I'm going.
Yes, Trina?
Here's your tea, Cousin Charlie.
Murder in cold blood for only $10,000. A cheap levy against life. $1 a day for 27 years. And Cousin Charlie is nearing 50. $1 a day for 27 years. And that is the price Jake Crowley and Trina has placed on life, with no rate of interest. The perspective on money and life becomes incredible when that perspective is twisted and warped by obsession. Back now to our story starring Bonita Granville. It is the following morning after solicitous Trina took Cousin Charlie a cup of hot tea, a cup of tea loaded with cyanide. A lethal charge sufficient to kill many Cousin Charlies. And perhaps this morning, Cousin Charlie lies sprawled in the guest chamber in the horribly contorted paroxysm of death. At least, that is the burning hope of Jake and his wife, Trina, as they recount their evil conspiracy in the breakfast room downstairs, their voices hushed by the tense mute of a desperate obsession.
I don't want to go up there, Jake. I just can't.
All right, you don't have to. Let me have the suicide note. I'll take it up and put it on the lampstand.
Must we call the police this morning?
Of course. But there's nothing to worry about. We simply tell them I went upstairs to call him for breakfast and found him, well, that way.
Jake.
Listen, Trina. I was thinking last night. There may be more than 10,000 in this for us. Charlie's a rich man, isn't he?
I think so.
And you're his only living relative, aren't you?
Yes.
All right, he's almost certain to have mentioned you in his will. Do you realize what that means, Trina? We'll be rich.
Rich? Oh, Jake, it must be wonderful to be rich.
You said it. Trina, we're both alike. I think that's why I love you so much.
And I love you, Jake. I always will.
Well, good morning.
My cousin Charlie.
Charlie?
Oh, what's the matter?
Nothing.
Here's that cup of tea, Trina.
Oh.
I must have fallen right to sleep last night. Didn't get a chance to drink it. Thanks, anyway.
Oh.
Well, come on. What are you staring at me for? Well, what do you got for breakfast?
Breakfast. Eggs.
Fine. Say, how about dishing me up a platter? I'm kind of in a hurry. Thought I'd go into town this morning and get a pair of temporary glasses.
Yes, I'll fix you something right away.
Oh, say, I meant to tell you. I used the phone in my room for a long-distance call yesterday. Hope you don't mind.
Oh, no, of course not.
Had to call my foreman at one of my ranches. We're going to enlarge. Finally got an okay with some building material. Figured I'm going up to look it over day after tomorrow.
You told the foreman you'd be there day after tomorrow?
Why, yeah. Sure. Say, how about them eggs?
Oh, sorry. Right away, Cousin Charlie.
Mm-hmm.
Jake and I had been very lucky. If Charlie had drunk the tea after making that phone call to his ranch, the police would have checked with the foreman and become suspicious. Yes, we had been lucky, but it hadn't solved our problem. So that evening...
Trina, did Charlie get back?
He's in the front room, listening to the radio.
Did he get his glasses?
Well, yes.
Good. There's only 2 days left, Trina.
Oh, I know, Jake, but...
Listen, this is foolproof. We'll tell him there's a package for him in town that he must sign for personally. We'll loan him the car.
How does that...
The skid chains are off, and the roads are slippery with snow. I've loosened a bolt in the master cylinder that breaks. Before he reaches town, all the hydraulic fluid will have leaked out.
You mean the brakes won't hold?
Call Charlie.
Oh, no, Jake, I can't do
that. We haven't much time. Call him, Trina.
It was easy to talk Charlie into going. And as the front door closed behind him, I felt relieved, exhilarated. I stood by the window listening for the car motor to start. I didn't hear it. Instead, I heard a voice calling.
Trina! Jake! Come here, quick!
Why, it's Cousin Charlie.
Sounds like he's on the porch. Open the door.
Charlie, what's wrong?
I slipped on steps.
Oh.
Don't seem to be able to get up.
Here.
Give me a hand, will you?
Yeah, here.
Oh. Be careful,
Jake. Let's get him into the house, Jake.
Yeah, all right. Take it easy, Charlie. Come on.
Charlie had sprained his ankle. We called a doctor. He advised Charlie to stay in bed, and he would pay him another visit in the morning. Jake found an old cane he had used when he had had a foot infection. We left it at Charlie's bedside and went downstairs. Jake was furious. The thing was getting to be an obsession with him.
I don't care, Trina. I don't care what's gone wrong. We can't wait any longer. We can't.
We won't be able to do it, Jake. You can see that. It just wasn't meant to be.
It was meant to be, all right. And it's going to be.
Oh, no. Don't you realize, Jake, there's something bigger than you or me.
There's nothing bigger than you or me. Listen, you've kept up the insurance on the house, haven't you?
Why, you know I have.
All right. This time we'll do it. There's plenty of kerosene in the basement. We'll burn this house to the ground and Cousin Charlie with it.
Oh, you can't.
We'll be in the garage, understand? We won't notice the fire until it's too late. Charlie started it with a cigarette, accidentally. He was smoking in bed.
But he's crippled. He'd never be able to get down the stairs.
Well, of course, that's the idea.
Oh, no, we couldn't do that to him.
We can and we will. Well, Trina, we've gone too far to stop now. Hello, Charlie. How do you feel?
Oh, a little better, thanks.
Say, Charlie, that money of yours, don't you think Trina and I'd better put it away for you?
Oh, I don't know. Nobody's going to rob me, are they?
Oh, no, of course not. I just thought, well, we have a wall safe downstairs, and inasmuch as you're laid up...
Oh, come to think of it, might not be a bad idea. There's my traveling kit over there. Take it down with you.
Fine.
Say, what do you got in that can there?
Oh, it's kerosene. We were just going down to the furnace. Thought we'd heat your room up a little for you.
Oh, well, thanks.
Oh, dear, I've spilled it. I'll get a cloth and clean it up right away.
Oh, don't bother, don't bother. It'll dry up.
Well, if you're sure you don't mind.
Oh, no, it's okay.
Here's a package of cigarettes, Charlie, in case you'd like to smoke.
Oh, well, thanks. You better keep them. I don't smoke.
You don't smoke?
No, sir.
Oh. Oh, that's right. I forgot. Come on, Trina. We'd better go downstairs.
But, Jake, regardless, why can't we tell the police that it started with a cigarette?
Oh, don't be a fool. Don't you think they'd discover he didn't smoke?
Oh.
No, we gotta find something besides a cigarette. What can it be?
What?
I'll get it. Hello? Speaking. Oh, hello, Evans. Yes? Yes? Hey, what? They're on the way over here now. Yeah. Yeah, I'm glad you called. Thanks. Goodbye.
What is it, Jake? Jake, what's wrong?
They've discovered the shortage at the bank, Trina.
Oh, no.
The investigators are on their way over here now. Evan said he thought I'd like to know. He's a nice kid.
But how? I thought the bank examiners were due until...
I don't know how. Trina. Trina, you said you loved me.
I do, Jake. Heaven help me for it, but I do.
We'll run away. You and I.
But supposing we're caught...
Well, we'll be caught if we stay here. Trina, we've got Charlie's 10,000. Maybe we'll be able to start again somewhere else.
Oh, do you think that this is the right...
Will you come with me, Trina?
Yes. Yes, Jake. I'll come with you.
Are you afraid?
No, not anymore.
They're probably at the house by now.
Jake, do you have to drive so fast?
Well, they'll be looking for us pretty soon.
But you're doing almost 70 and the roads is... Jake?
What's the matter?
Jake? Good Lord, Jake! The brake! The brake!
Hello? Who? Well, this is Charlie Barton. They... what? Both of them? Yes. I'm Mrs. Crowley's cousin. Well, I have a sprained ankle. But if you'll send someone... Yes. Yes, I'll come down and identify the bodies. What? What? $10,000? That's strange. I was planning on giving them that money as a present. Why? I thought the world of those two kids.
Been listening to Obsession. Through the worldwide facilities of the United States Armed Forces Radio and Television Service.